stay on the cutting edge with the Plastic Surgery Channel.
Hello and welcome back to Plastic Surgery News. A 43-year-old woman in England has received a cash settlement after undergoing three plastic surgeries on her face, each one more damaging than the last. The London Daily Mail and FoxNews.com reported that the suffering of Beverly Binks began when she consulted Transform Medical Group in Newcastle in March 2005 for an eye and jaw lift. The surgery was a bust. Her facial skin was overly tightened when too much fat was removed from underneath one of her eyes. This left Binks with a distorted face, which was then advised to correct through a second and ultimately a third surgery, both of which did more damage. The cosmetic surgery fiasco came to a head in 2006, when Binks was finally left with improper symmetry in her face that also made her ears droop. In her own words, she has been left with a butchered face. Binks has not sought further corrective surgery and says her appearance has affected her livelihood and prevents her from even wanting to leave her home. She has said that people stare at her in public, and she has even been asked at random if she suffered a stroke. Her 25-year marriage nearly ended as a result of the ordeal, and Binks has admitted to feeling suicidal. Binks recently was awarded an undisclosed sum in a settlement with the doctors who performed these three botched surgeries on her face. Transform Medical Group, citing a confidentiality agreement, has insisted that legally the case resides between Binks and the two surgeons, not the group itself. Sadly, it seems that negligent plastic surgery continues to be a widespread concern in the United Kingdom, following the July death of Denise Hendry, wife of Colin Hendry, a former Scotland soccer player. According to a study by market research company Mintel, the cosmetic surgery industry in the United Kingdom has grown nearly tenfold since 2002, when it was valued at £143 million. As of this year, the research shows the industry is estimated to be worth £1.2 billion. But it was in 2002 when Denise Hendry underwent liposuction and then experienced several complications through the years that resulted in more than 20 additional surgeries. During her final surgery this past May, she went into a coma and was later taken off life support. The rising demand for plastic surgery in the United Kingdom clearly is the driving force behind the industry's tremendous leap. But this also has led to an increase in unsuccessful operations and patients who complain of malpractice. British sources speculate that these problems may come from a lack of proper regulation among practicing cosmetic surgeons. Procedures such as Botox injections and dermal fillers are presently not subject to governmental regulations in the United Kingdom. What's more, surgeons who don't specialize chiefly in cosmetic surgery are still permitted to perform it. In response to public concern, the UK charity Action Against Medical Accidents is said to be developing an independent group that will scrutinize the actual success rate among surgeons who will carry out cosmetic procedures. The new initiative from Action Against Medical Accidents is designed to give prospective patients a better idea of what to expect from a cosmetic surgery procedure. The group will also make support available for other people who suffer complications after undergoing these operations. Well, we'll be right back. It's time to take a quick break. We'll have more plastic surgery news, including a proposed tax on plastic surgery. Don't go away.